Hey guys, what's going on? We got a quick news update for you for the JP side, the global side of Dokkan Battle. Sorry about that. And I'm going to go over all of it. It's really awesome. There's a whole bunch of awesome stuff coming, and it's all actually going to be released within the next 24 hours. So if y'all are ready, let's go jump into it. We have a whole bunch of new cards that are getting Dokkan Awakenings, or not new cards, we're getting a whole bunch of new Dokkan Awakenings for cards we've been waiting for. And a lot of them are legit. We really wanted them. We also have the release of Ultra Instinct Goku on the global side, which is phenomenal. Can't wait for that. That's happening at 8 p.m. PST, by the way, guys. So that should be around the same time that I'll go on live stream and actually do a full live stream with this. Because if they actually have the banner and it has like the Super Saiyan Goku from the Korra event, I am going to be summoning on that, because it's the only Super Saiyan Goku I don't have and I want him. I might be doing that. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see, but probably. Anyway, the Goku's form is called Sign, not Omen, like it was on the JP side. We also have information about Christmas summoning tickets. So, legit. Can't wait. It looks like the scheduled Dokkan Awakenings start at 4 p.m. PST, so we'll be able to do it in the middle of today. So, we have about 12, 13, 14, 15 hours, and we should be able to start using Dokkan Awakenings of all these guys. So, let's go talk about it. We have the Nova Shenron, which definitely, which Dokkan Awakens now. His Dokkan Awaken is very legit, really, really good. Especially for a Shadow Dragons team, you're really going to want to have this unit Dokkan Awaken. His leader ability is actually pretty decent if you don't have a tech leader, because he's tech type, key plus 3, HP and defense plus 100%. So he doesn't give the attack buff, which really stinks, but if you have like a leader that gives the attack buff, he can come in handy if you don't have one. That way you could take on essentially primarily agility events. His super attack does supreme damage, which is still kind of whack, but raises his attack for 3 turns. And his passive skill gives himself key plus 3 and attack plus 90%, so he's super self-reliant. And he does hit pretty hard. He also has some decent link skills, as Shocking Speed, Gentleman, Cold Judgment, GT, Shadow Dragons, and Shattering the Limit. So he will be able to link with some units on the Shadow Dragons team. Really good, awesome card. Honestly, definitely focus on him to get him Dokkan Awakened. The next one is going to be the Super Saiyan Goku. This is the one that I was telling you about. This is one I actually mentioned earlier today in the earlier video about how he has a how the only Super Saiyan that I don't have is this Goku, or at least the SSR variant of this Goku. And I have all the Super Saiyan Gokus from the crossover, the One Piece crossover that came out like a year and a half ago. Now, I've been waiting to get this guy. If he's on the banner, I might actually consider pulling on the banner so I can try and grab him. He's awesome. His leader ability, when he gets Dokkan Awakened, is all types, HP, attack, and defense plus 50%. That's kind of whack. His super attack causes supreme damage with a high chance to stun the enemy. So he's pretty cool on a physical team because he can stun enemies. His passive skills, though, it is kind of whack. Attack plus 10,000, defense plus 5,000, HP is 50% or above. If they lower that to 50%, that 50% to like 30%, and actually gave him like a percentage-based passive, like 100% on his attack, he'd be awesome. But unfortunately, it's not 10%. 10,000 is just cool. I really just want it more for collective purposes. He does have the standard link skills though, Golden Warrior, Saiyan Warrior Ace, Super Saiyan, Z Fighters, Prepare for Battle, Shattering the Limit, standard Super Saiyan link skills. Pretty cool unit. He's awesome because he stuns. Outside of that, I mean, he's not someone who you're going to need to run on a team, but if you're lacking units, he's definitely a solid unit due to his link skills, and he's not a horrible hitter. He's not great by any means, but he's not horrible. The next one is going to be the Korra, the Meta Korra. He finally gets his Dokkan Awakening. Now, this guy is a really good unit for support on an extreme intelligence team. He's really good, and the reason why is because he gives key plus 2 for extreme type enemies or allies, and he gives attack plus 30% for all allies. So as you guys probably know, on a Kid Buu team, if you're running all the optimal units, there's not a lot of good link skills for key. Actually, any of the units, there really has no key links with any of the Kid Buus, so, or Kid Buu with anyone else. So this really comes in handy as a support unit, and he gives a really nice attack buff. Outside of that, he does supreme damage, greatly lowers the defense of the enemy. He has auto regeneration for recovering 3 HP, shocking speed, nightmare, strongest clan in space, thirst for conquest, fear of faith, and shattering the limit. Not only is he decent for a Kid Buu team, just an extreme team in general because of his passive skill, and he has some pretty solid, like, fear and faith, thirst for conquest, strongest clan in space, nightmare, are all really good link skills. I think he's only technically missing, I think, one link skill that would make him the cream of the crop in terms of for a villain's team, but overall he's really good, plus shattering the limit too. You know, there's a lot of good extreme units that are shattering the limit, so overall he's a really good solid unit. If you guys have him, definitely recommend Dokkan Awakening him. The next one is going to be the Dokkan Awakening of the intelligence, the Android 13. Now, his leader ability is tech type enemy attack minus 43%. It's not like you really needed it anymore anyway, but if you run a double intelligence, you know, I was kind of wondering how this would come into play on a on the battlefield road type thing when you're trying to do trying to complete it for an extreme intelligence team, because the enemy's going to be doing almost no damage to you if you have a double lead. So if that happens, I'll probably do it. I think someone's already done it, but we'll see. He does supreme damage to the enemy and lowers defense. His passive skill changes tech spheres to rainbow, which is, you know, he keeps that. But he now gives himself an additional 50% attack. He doesn't really have anything that great. Red Ribbon Army, Android Assault, Tough as Nails, Metamorphosis, Nightmare, Fear, and Faith, and Shattering the Limit. So the last three are really primary links. Metamorphosis can be handy. Extreme cards, units, do have that, so he's something cool. He is definitely an orb changer, and orb changers definitely are beneficial to teams. So if you have him, I mean, don't get me wrong, at the end of the day, you're gonna want to Dokken Waken everyone. I just wanted to let you know about it, but he is pretty cool because of that orb changing capability. The next one is going to be the Technique Android 13. He gets a Dokken Awakening as well. Let's see, his leader ability, Technique, Strength, and Physical type, key plus 2, attack and defense plus 40%, not that great. Super attack is supreme damage, lowers defense. His passive skill is key plus 4, attack plus 70% when a key is 8 or more. So essentially he launches super attacks whenever you have 8 key, and he gives himself a nice 70% attack buff, so he's super self-reliant. And honestly, on a team like this, you only need 2 key orbs if you don't have any link skills hit off. But outside of that, same link skill set, Red Ribbon Army, Android Assault, Tough as Nails, Metamorphosis, Nightmare, Fear and Faith, and Shattering the Limit. So he'll be definitely getting off a lot of supers, especially if you hit off at least one of those key links. Overall, you know, I wouldn't recommend running him, but you can run him. Both of these guys are kind of whack, but they're like B-tier units, I would say. Maybe A-tier, like primary replacements, but nothing too crazy. Next, well, we're going to talk about him in a minute. We have the new Super Bowl, not the new, the Dokken Awakening of the Super Saiyan 2 Vegeta, the agility guy. He's actually pretty legit. He does agility, technique, and physical type, key plus 3, HP, and attack plus 30%. So he's not bad. He gives the two stat buffs that you really want to have. Yeah, he's not horrible. He's definitely going to be good for you if you are a newer player and you have him. So when you Dokken Awaken him, he'll be a decent leader until you get better leaders, like 70% leaders or higher. Super attack, he still does supreme damage. I believe he did supreme damage in his SSR variant. He does attack and defense plus 90% when HP is 80% or below. Kind of sucks that there's that restrictive of 80% or below, but once you're below that 80%, he's pretty legit, because attack and defense, he's going to be defending really well, and he'll be doing a ridiculous amount of attacks. Unfortunately, you know, you have to get below that 80% for that to happen. So, I mean, you take some, you win some, you lose some, but that kind of goes along with how the agility team is. They tank very, very well. Having him on the team will help tank. Link skills are pretty standard. Super Saiyan, Saiyan Warrior Race, Golden Warrior, Royal Lineage, Revival, Prepared for Battle, and Shattering the Limit. So it's a typical Vegeta Link skill set for the most part. Super Saiyan, Vegeta Link skill set. Really decent unit, not horrible at all. He's definitely would be an A-tier unit in my opinion. There are definitely units you would want to run in place of him, but he's definitely not bad. The next one is going to be the Extreme Majin Buu. I think I got mine up to Super Attack 10 now. You could feed the SR physical ones, Z Awaken them to SSR, for a 50% chance of increasing this one's Super Attack. I forgot if I got him how high he is. He's not a great unit overall, but he's decent. Leader ability is Technique, Intelligence, Strength type, Key plus 3, HP and Attack plus 30%. So again, for those three attribute types, he'll be a good leader for you until you get something better. He's like a B-tier leader. His super attack is supreme damage and raises attack for 3 turns. His passive skill, it's actually kind of funny because it's better than the Super Saiyan Goku. Attack plus 18,000 when HP is 99% or below. So that's really not horrible. 18,000, you know, flat out boost. So you all know how we feel about flat out boost. It's not the greatest thing in the world, but it's cool. It's there. You can go ahead and do it. He has link skills of Majin, Brutal Beatdown, Kamehameha, Infinite Regeneration, Nightmare, Wall, Standing Tall, and Shattering the Limit. He'll do good on a Majin Buu team. Not horrible. He'd be cool on a Majin Buu team. Outside of that, you can get up to Super Attack 10 pretty easily just because of those physical SR Buus. And that's all that there is to it with that. We're going to talk about the actual Goku over here, the Ultra Instinct Goku. I can't believe we were getting him so early. I kind of figured we were going to get him at some point, but I thought that we were going to get at least the 120 leads out of the way first. So he's getting released alongside of this. What did I tell you guys? We are going to be caught up with the JP side very soon. They're releasing this in tandem with the 120 leads, and I'm pretty sure we're going to get Broly pretty soon as well. This is going to overlap with our with these guys, by the way, just so you all know. There's some overlapping going on, and we're going to get caught up with JP pretty soon. I'm pretty sure we are. Anyway, he has Realm of Gods category key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 120%, or Intelligence type key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 40%. His super attack, Kamehameha, raises attack, causes immense damage. That's awesome. I'm pretty sure that's greatly raises attack. I'm not 100% sure, though, so I'll talk about that later. Not in this video. Passive skill is a new feeling. Attack and defense plus 70%, plus an additional key plus 3, attack plus 70%, and a high chance to evade the enemy's attack for 7 turns when HP is 50% or below once only. Wow, that's a mouthful. An additional key plus 3, attack plus 70%, and a high chance to evade enemy's attack. Wow. For 7 turns with HP once only. That's ridiculous. That's just ridiculous. For the first 7 turns, if you ever go below 50% HP, he just becomes a beast. So that's pretty legit. Anyway, Link skills are Kamehameha, Prepare for Battle, Godly Power, Over in a Flash, and the First Awaken. That's actually pretty legit. He has some decent Link skills. I'm definitely going to do a team building on him. I have a lot of team building videos I'm going to have to do for you guys now, just because of this and everything else that's coming out. But yeah, super hyped about that. Outside of that, I wanted to talk about tickets, because where are you tickets? There we go. So the Christmas summon ticket. We don't have any real information on how we're getting this or anything. We just know that it's here. Summon ticket for Christmas ticket summon. One ticket is required to perform a single summon. We don't know what the banner is going to be like. We don't know any other information about it, but we know that it's here. So once it's available, I'll definitely let you guys know. But yeah, that's it, guys. We have a whole, that's all the new information that just got downloaded on the global side of Dokkan Battle. I'm super hyped for it. I can't wait for this to go live, and it's going to be going live really, really soon. So yeah. Anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. Make sure to subscribe if you're new. I'll definitely be doing a live stream tomorrow with all this information, so make sure to stop by. It's going to probably be around 11 o'clock p.m. Eastern time. So, set your clocks, and I'll go ahead and do that. Anyway, guys, thank you. I'll catch you all later. Peace.